support that you've given us. Your ongoing help, sharing, and liking have helped Psych2Go continue our mission to make content on psychology and mental health more accessible to everyone. So thank you. Now, let's continue. What do you understand from the term psychotic disorder? Are you familiar with the term psychosis? What are some of the defining features of a psychotic disorder? Knowing the answer to these can be really helpful in recognizing a disorder early and ensuring proper treatment. Here are 5 signs of a psychotic disorder. Before we begin, we would like to mention that this video is created for educational purposes only and is not intended to substitute a professional diagnosis. If you suspect you or someone else may have a psychotic disorder or any mental health condition, we highly advise you to seek help from a qualified mental health professional. Now, back to the video. Number 1, delusions. Delusions are fixed beliefs that do not change, even when there's evidence that goes against it. The most common type is a persecutory delusion, the belief that someone is out to get them. There's also a grandiose delusion, where a person believes he or she is exceptional beyond everyone else. Do you know of someone who strongly believed that the world would end in 2020? That's an example of nihilistic delusion, which is where they believe a major catastrophe will occur. If a person is developing any such delusions, it might be a good reason to visit your therapist, as it can be caused by an underlying psychotic disorder. Number 2, hallucinations. Have you ever heard about someone seeing things that others couldn't? People who perceive things that are not actually there may be experiencing a hallucination. This could be the belief that you see a person when they're really not there, or hear voices when there's no one talking. However, it's important to note that experiencing hallucinations alone does not mean you have a psychotic disorder. It may be a common experience, especially in certain cultural contexts. However, consulting a therapist might be a good idea, just to be sure. Number 3, disorganized thinking. Do you remember that time we went to the amusement park? Oh, I really want to study right now. Maybe we should book a trip to Italy. This sentence is an example of disorganized thinking. Disorganized thinking is often inferred from a person's speech and is reflected when a person constantly switches from one topic to another. Another instance of disorganized thinking is derailment, where a person just goes on numerous and many unrelated tangents. If you notice such discrepancies in speech, be sure to consult with your therapist to get to its root cause. Number 4, grossly disorganized or abnormal motor behavior, including catatonia. Behavior is any observable action one does usually. However, for those suffering from a psychotic disorder, even everyday behavior becomes a challenge. Deviation in behavior from the norm is a major telltale sign of an underlying psychotic disorder. Disorganized behavior can be manifested in many ways, like in unpredictable agitation. In one such disorder, catatonia, a person has decreased reactivity to the environment. They could completely stop moving and remain still in a certain posture for long periods of time, which is called mutism and stupor, or excessively move with no purpose, which is called catatonic excitement. And number 5, negative symptoms. It does not mean that the person is negative emotionally. It's called negative because they lack features that the typical person may have. It refers to an absence of certain factors that are present in those not suffering from a disorder. For example, a person may exhibit less goal-directed movements, called avolition, or be less able to experience positive emotions from pleasurable things, called anhedonia. A person might also show less emotional expression by reducing facial contact, eye contact, or movements of the hands or arms that normally complement speech. These are 5 signs of a psychotic disorder as indicated in the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, or the DSM-5. However, the purpose of this video is to inform, and by no means should be considered as a means for self-diagnosis. If you feel you or someone around you can relate to any of these signs, it's highly recommended that you opt for professional help. If you found this video insightful, be sure to like and share this video with someone who might benefit from it. Subscribe to Psych2Go for more content, and thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.